欢迎收看足球一周报，我是 Roy， 足球大小事带你一手掌握。穆兰联赛的第一阶段已经完成了，而第二阶段也悄悄的开始了，刚好本轮休踢，让我们来一起来回顾穆兰联赛的战绩。我们先看积分榜，目前位在榜首的是五战全胜的台中蓝鲸，而且他们总共进了21球，平均一场进4球，实力非同小可。第二跟第三名同样是9分，台北 Playrun 少踢一场，以净胜球压过了花莲女子足球队，排在第二。第四名是只有一胜的高雄阳性，而最后一名是还没有打开胜利之门的新北国际。联赛榜的积分看完了，大家已经好奇射手榜的战况如何，马上为你送上射手榜。目前射手榜的第一名是进7球的包新璇，而且他在4月28号对上新北国际的时候上演了帽子戏法，有三位球员同样进了5球，包括台北 Play One 的陈彦平、花莲女子足球队的林凯琳，还有台中蓝鲸的李秀琴。当中林凯琳也曾经在5月12号对上新北国际的时候上演帽子戏法。接下来有4位球员同时进了3球，包括花莲女子足球队的杨雅涵、台中蓝鲸的何轩怡、台北 Play One 的林雅涵，还有台中蓝鲸的赖丽琴。眼尖的观众朋友可能有发觉，在射手榜的前八名里面有4位球员都是来自台中蓝鲸，所以台中蓝鲸是一支多点开花的球队，这意味着他们很多球员都有进球的能力，会让防守方非常的头痛。接下来穆兰联赛下一个比赛日将会是6月10号，地点是高雄，会进行2场比赛，由花莲女子足球队对上台北 Play One， 还有高雄阳性对上台中蓝鲸，也希望各位观众朋友多多进场支持，为他们加油。正当我们穆兰联赛休息的时候，汽甲联赛就打得如火如荼，马上为你送上汽甲联赛的比赛精华。
2018企业甲级联赛第5是台南市，直塞被拦截走，徐毅再度拿到球，一个直塞非常好的传球，没有越位。我们看看这个球，策动了这一波的进攻，做一个非常好的直塞球，由嘉煌做一个非常好的一个跑位 timing 时机抓得刚刚好。我们看看这个球传出去，其实射一个漂亮的传球，还有一个漂亮的 finish， 把这个球打进去了航员的球门。这个数据是非常重要，台底拿到球到底线球45度传出来，我们看看射门，起脚射门非常漂亮， excellent， 非常漂亮的一个传球，由1-0落后，现在追成2-1领先。哇哦，非常漂亮的一个球，徐毅直接一个旋球，然后球直接进门了。
转移到了左侧，洪志贵把球传到禁区中央，队友迎上一脚，空间创造出来，周正首开纪录。也没收。这个球洪志贵压上再倒进来，空了，漂亮，陈胜卫迎上来，第一根门柱前六码区域边缘接应洪志贵的妙传，球给进来，给得太慢，还有第二波机会，周整压上来，高伟杰禁区外围一个超球成功，给陈宏卫创造了机会，进去了。这个是高伟杰在攻击区的一个逼抢成功，为台底创造另外一次一个破门的机会。高伟杰底线把球传进去，空了，传向了第二个门前，由陈宏伟及时速度压上去， 漂亮的射入了左边边柱的一个边角。周宇杰打一个地面穿越给尤嘉华，速度摆脱，有机会，漂亮抓住了，就是这么的干净利落、简单而实用。周宇杰在右边中场一个直塞穿越球，段誉看如何来守住，扑错别。轻易的被这个十二码花球给直接射到了出联赛这个赛场的这个台城红狮队队友套一脚来跑位，拉开空间，王伟民斜线长球，有机会，漂亮，抓住了，抓住了。这球由黄伟民斜线长球马克首开纪录，打破了这个台城市的防线。打进去，漂亮，哎呀，太美妙了，这球射得太漂亮了。鸣笛开始，看这球踢向球门的右边，然后邱一红补错边，这球成功破网，1-0开开，双方攻防之间来较力。出点，这球进去了，这一球就在门前，大家一团乱的乱局当中，守门员的视线被阻碍了，然后这一球直接掉进了这个球门里面。
经过5月27号的比赛，西甲联赛的排名有些微的变动，目前排在第一名是6战全胜的北师大同，那第二名是本轮赢了6-1的台体光雷。第三名是跟第二名同分，只输了净胜球的高师台电。第四名还是航源 FC， 而第五名是台南市。第六名是台城狮，而七八名的位置都还是皇家蔚蓝跟国家储训。看完积分榜，马上为你送上射手榜。目前进球最多的是台城狮的 Javier Furness， 总共进了9球，而且他曾经连续2轮拿到帽子戏法。接下来有3位球员同样是进了7球，包括是航源 FC 的尤嘉煌、北师大同的 Mark Fernandes， 还有台体光雷的周成。相信大家对 Mark Fernandes 一点都不陌生，没错，他就是上一届进了38球而得到金靴奖的球员。接着进了6球有2位球员，分别是北师大同的陈瑞杰，还有台体光雷的李振宇。本季从中国大陆回到西甲联赛的朱恩乐也进了5球。西甲联赛的下个比赛日将会是6月6号，地点在辅大，由台城市对上航源 FC。希望观众朋友也多多进场为他们加油打气。那我们先休息一下，广告回来为你送上精彩的世足分析。欢迎回到足球一周报。我们还是非常荣幸的请到台湾男足总教练 Gary 来跟我们一起分析世足赛。Welcome Gary。
Hello， 你好。
上一集呢，我们分析了 C D 组的情势。那 C 组呢 ，Gary 是看好法国跟丹麦，而 D 组呢，大推阿根廷跟克罗埃西亚。那我们今天呢，来到 E 组。我们分析 E 组之前呢，先知道 E 组有什么厉害的国家。这小组呢非常厉害，有强国巴西、瑞士、哥斯达黎加还有塞尔维亚。那根据的四组呢，不晓得 Gary 教练有什么看法呢 ？So we've got to Group E, Brazil, Switzerland, Costa Rica, and Serbia. Which two teams do you pick?
Well, obviously Brazil would be the first.
For sure, yeah, Brazil. Yeah.
And then for me, Serbia.
Serbia. So how about the other two teams, Switzerland?
Well, Switzerland have some good players like Xhaka from Arsenal. That's a good defensive, strong midfielder who can also play forward. I think.Again, they don't have enough quality to get out of this group. They do have some good players around them, but I just don't think they will have enough.
So how about Sukuri?
Yeah, good player
he's a
again.
Good player also.
Good player again, but again, I don't think he's going to break through the Serbian,
also the consistency problem. Yeah,
I think so too. I think they have to consistently play well at this level and play together. But again, it's going to be depth of the squad, and I don't think they have enough.
How about Costa Rica?
Costa Rica, what a wonderful story.
A miracle
story.
Team, yeah?
Yeah, story from the last World Cup, weren't they? They were the fairy tale team, the team that qualified that nobody thought they could. Obviously, the goalkeeper they have, Navas,
yeah,
who's playing at Real Madrid, he'll have to be key for them to survive. I don't think, again, they will have enough
yeah, only a goalkeeper can help what...
No, I mean, he can set the defence and do everything and start the attack, but the rest of the players have to finish it. So, yeah, I just don't think they have enough.
I see you picked Serbia, right? Mm. So how do you find the team?
I think Serbia are solid. I mean, they're a very, very strong defensive unit. Yeah, very difficult to break down. If you look at their records and stats, they don't concede that many goals. They're led by Matic,
yeah.
Who I think is probably the best transfer of last year in the Premier League. The way that Mourinho was able to steal him from Chelsea and put him in his team was fantastic. So he is a player that makes everybody else look good. He does it at club level. He does the work and allows other people to express their attacking flair and be sexy. So he's the guy that works hard. He's like the Yi Wei.
Yeah,
he's like the Yi Wei of Taiwan. You know, he is a player that does all the work and gives the ball to other people to perform. So, yeah, I think Matic is a fantastic player. And also, they've got other players in that squad too that can perform at this level.
So do you think they can reach the final? Serbia?
No, I don't. I don't think they will go too far into the competition, but I think they will qualify from the group.
I see. So how about Brazil?
We could sit here and talk about Brazilian players, Coutinho, you know, you've
Firmino.
Got Firmino, you've got Willian, you've got players right through that.
Jesus.
And Jesus, he's an exciting player. Yeah. He's just won the Premier League with Man City. He's young, he's 19, 20 years old. Can he perform at the next level is going to be the question on a lot of people's lips. But if he does, it'll be his breakthrough tournament. He has the potential, he has the ability, he has the players around him. You know, you've also got to look at, you know, the defence of Brazil. Can they fill that gap?
Because yeah, you're right.
You think about the last World Cup they played, the last game. They were absolutely humiliated by Germany.
Yes, you're right. Yeah.
So I think they're going to come out with a little bit more passion to show the world that they are back at this level. They definitely have the squad to perform, so it'll be very interesting.
So do you think all the football stars in this team can get it together to play well in this time?
Well, the good question is, Roy, if they don't, they can expect more scores like they did against Germany. So I think that was a lesson learned, and I don't think they'll fall down that same pathway again. I think they've matured a little bit, they've learned, and they'll come out with a little bit more structure.
Yeah, absolutely. 谢谢 Gary 大卫的分析啊。这一组呢，除了巴西以外呢，其实三队的实力都很接近，而且每一队有自己的特色。尤其是瑞士跟塞尔维尔呢，他们竞争是非常激烈，相信他们一定有一轮的龙争虎斗啊。那本组呢，其实真的非常有看头，光是巴西就很好看了。不过呢，我们等一下介绍的下一组更有看头，因为呢，上一届的冠军就在下一组了。我们来到下一组 F 组，我们有德国、墨西哥、瑞典跟韩国，哦，这四队呢，不晓得 Gary 教练会看好哪两队呢 ？So we come to Group F. We've got Germany, Mexico, Sweden, and also South Korea. So which two teams will pick? Germany for sure, right?
Germany, I think, will win the World Cup, so they have to qualify, I guess.
Win the World Cup. They said win the World Cup. Yeah.
So I think they have enough quality to do that. I think they'll win the group, and I think Mexico will come second.
How come you didn't pick Sweden? Are they not playing good?
They're playing okay, but the big question is going to be on Ibra, isn't it? Is he going to play in the competition? So if he decides to play or they decide to pick him, I think he will change the dynamics. But I don't think, again, they have enough depth to get through this group. And I think Mexico are definitely undervalued. I think they're coming under the radar as well. And I think they're a lot better than people give them credit for.
So talking about Ibrahimovic, do you think it's a good idea to bring him back to the national team?
If he was playing for Taiwan, he would definitely be brought back. You know, he's now playing for LA Galaxy. Again, he's scoring wonder goals. He's making an impact. He's a world-class player. And in a tournament, it suits him because there's less games.
Okay, yeah.
Now, over a season, now his age, maybe he's too old to compete at the highest level for a season. But for a tournament, I think... Of course you'd try to use him if you wanted to play.
You're right. So how about South Korea?
South Korea struggled. They've struggled in qualification. They haven't found the form. obviously players like Son at Tottenham is doing very, very well. And I think they just don't have enough quality to get through. The coach hasn't had much success since he took over. They've got defensive problems. They let a lot of goals in during qualification. Yeah, I don't see South Korea.
You know, in 2002, they did very well. They nearly get into the final.
Yeah.
So will you think they can do that as well this time?
No, I don't think they can. I think that was a lot to do with being the host, and I think a lot to do with the coach. And I don't think they have the same environment that they had back then.
So you mentioned Mexico, right? Mm. So how do you find a team? You think Mexico?
Mexico is a team of not many stars.
You're right.
You know, you can't really name too many top level players, but they're a great team. And if you look at their record for the past 50 games, I think it was, from the coach, he's only lost 6 games. And he's in a very
good result,
and he's in a difficult group in CONCACAF.
Yeah.
You know, he's got to get past America, he's got to get past all these different teams that are in that part of the world, and they qualify with style. And I think this is a team that people need to take a little bit more serious.
So any stars we have to pay attention to?
Well, Hernandez, you've got to look at immediately. So, you know, he's the focal point of the team. But like I said, it's not a team that has star. It's not like a France or a Brazil. It's a good team unit, and I think he's obviously the vocal point of the team, and hopefully he can be a little bit more consistent than he has been with his club.
Problem, West Ham. Yeah. He's playing so fluctuating.
Yeah, exactly.
So come to Germany.
Yeah.
Too many to talk to. Mm-hmm. Germany. So how do you find a team?
I think Germany are world
class.
Can
they win this again? Win the cup again?
Yeah, I think they will. I think they will, because they've just got so much depth. And, you know, if you look at their qualification, if you look at the players that they have available, you know, they have so much quality right through the team. We could sit all day and talk about their players. But one thing they have, they're a machine, and they're used to winning. They have a winning mentality. They have a winning culture. And I think they're coming into this very quietly confident. And you know, I think they will win the World Cup.
I agree too. 好，谢谢 Gary 的分析。那不管 Ibrahimovic 会不会回去瑞典，其实瑞典目前已经踢得还不错了。不过呢，他们要跟老大哥德国比呢，我觉得还是有一点点距离，还是有点小吃亏。那不过呢，他们确实有实力呢，可以打败刚刚 Gary 教练弄的墨西哥的。因为我觉得墨西哥跟他们其实真的是差不多，所以期待他们有机会可以踢进去下一个回合。那我们下一集呢，会来分析 G 组跟 H 组的比赛，所以请大家继续锁定我们的节目哦。好，我们分析到这边，拜拜。
拜拜。
欢迎回到足球一周报。再过两星期，四足赛就要开始了。本届四足的最大惊奇，应该就是不少传统的强队，像是意大利、荷兰、美国等，他们都纷纷落马。取而代之就是一些后起之秀。曾经在欧洲杯杀进八强的冰岛就是其中之一。不过冰岛他们之前在 FIFA 的排名是在百名之后，所以他们的成功是非常值得台湾球员的一个借鉴。那我们一起来看台湾球员如何看待这个冰岛惊奇。
冰岛全国人民约32万人，国土面积只有台湾的3倍大，却踢进这次四足赛的决赛圈。除临近欧洲足球文化盛行外，最重要的是他们拥有自己的足球体系。
Well, the biggest difference is that football is within the culture in Iceland, and it's starting to become that way here in Taiwan. When you look at Iceland, 70% of the coaches that work with the elite players are B-licensed coaches, and 30% of those that work with the elite players are A-licensed coaches. So the coaching that they are getting at a young age is of a very high level, and we have to follow that same process. Also, they've created what they need for their country. So for example, they have built all these different football homes because it's so cold outside, they have to train inside. So they've looked at what they need. They haven't copied Spain or England or Germany. They just said, well, what do we need? And we must do the same. We must find what we need to develop. And for sure, it's facilities, it's better coaching, it's more interest in football, and these things will help to develop the game. But it goes to show, anybody can do it if they have the drive and desire to do it.
冰岛的表现对国内的球员是一个很大的鼓舞，或许台湾未来也能登上世界杯的舞台。
也希望我们台湾跟他们一样，可能有这个机会慢慢达到世界杯，然后也看可不可以有以后的几年，然后年轻的选手他们有办法把台湾的足球带到世界杯里面的会内赛这样。
既然冰岛可以的话，那台湾也一定可以，就是需要大家去努力，就是不仅是我们球员，然后还有我们国内支持的民众，然后粉丝，我觉得要一起去打造这个环境，所以我们才有更有动力去往这个目标前进。
世界杯是一个很大的目标，如果要朝着这个目标前进，台湾现在就要开始改变。
So now it's time to put the action where the mouth is, because there's a lot of talk about professional leagues and stadiums and improving football. Now we must do it. And if we do it, there's no reason in the world in 10 years' time people aren't talking about us like we're talking about Iceland.
台湾是这几年慢慢的进步，然后因为冰岛他们的周围都是欧洲欧盟国家，他们会想要跳进去欧盟踢职业赛，但我们台湾现在比较欠缺的就是职业队，我们只能往大陆啊、东南亚这样做发展。当然，就希望能在台湾有职业队踢，这样也不用跑到异地，因为去异地真的有时候很想家。
再进去，假动作成了围追入头顶。
我们永远都会记得，在2017年台湾对上巴林，奇迹式的逆转胜，场边的民众忘情呐喊，希望台湾男足的奇迹也可以在世界杯上演。Freedom Sports 综合报道。
要台湾踢进世足赛的决赛圈，真的是遥远的梦想。不过没关系，我们一步一步来完成。首先，我们先要在下一届的世足赛外围赛里面争取晋级，希望可以在更高的层次为台湾摇旗呐喊。提到世足赛，各大品牌都为世足推出限量商品，而宇舶表也为他们推出了世足官方限量的腕表。让我们一起来看看他们的发表会吧。
宇舶表自2010年南非世界杯开始，已连续三届成为 FIFA 世界杯足球赛的官方指定实际。每一届世界杯所推出的限量腕表，都让足球迷们趋之若鹜。
我们每一次的世界杯，我们会推出我们的限量腕表之外，在世界杯之后或之前，我们也会有一些其他的跟足球相关的产品。
台湾男足总教练 Gary White 也参与了这次的发布记者会。在现场畅谈了他对于台湾男足在未来参加世界杯的愿景。
So one day we want Taiwan to be in the World Cup. That's the big plan. So it's a long process, but we're getting there. Our first thing is to get into the top 100, which we're moving very closely.
台湾男足的总教练受邀到发布记者会，可见台湾男足的好表现在企业间已经开始受到了注目。
我们过去也有跟棒球的合作的联名，我们当然在足球界我们也不会缺席。
希望国内有更多企业能关注台湾足球，如果有企业的支持，国内的足球也能拥有更多资源去靠近世界更高的水平。 Freedom Sports 综合报道。
没想到男足代表队的总教练 Gary White 也受邀请参加世足赛的商业活动，这意味着我们台湾的足球慢慢受到重视了。希望观众朋友继续支持台湾足球，也多多关注我们的节目《足球一周报》。我是 Roy， 谢谢大家支持，我们下周再见，拜拜。